All right, what's up, everyone? Another pickup video here on the channel. It's going to be a good one. However, this is going to be quick, this little segment right here, because I've decided to make this pickup video centered around the Nintendo Switch presentation, which is this Thursday night. But right now, it's a Monday night. I just got home from work. I got my work shirt on. And here's all the packages that I have so far that I'm going to be opening Thursday night, in anticipation of that big Nintendo Switch presentation. However, quickly here on Monday night, I want to open up this package that I got from GameStop. I took advantage of their 25% off retro selection. And I just want to open it because they have a 7-day return policy. And I want to make sure if it's not in the condition I want it, I can return it, and I'm not gonna get screwed on that, even though Friday or Thursday is 3 days from now. That would give me plenty of time. I don't want to fuck with it this weekend. I'd get it done tomorrow night after work when I'm out and about already. I believe I ordered 3 PS1 games. And I tried to game it in the pictures. They were all in the boxes, but you know, they tell you not indicative of what you may receive. So if anything here is disc only, which I see it is, it's getting returned. I don't want it. So, okay, this one. Awesome. Panzer Dragoon Orta. I thought I ordered all PS1 stuff. But cool. There's the disc and an envelope in here. Manuals right there. Sweet. Panzer Dragoon Orta getting added to my Xbox collection. All right, what do we have here? Oh, sweet! It's with the case. All right. They put the disc in an envelope. Oh, maybe. Let me take a look. Maybe there are two different games in this. No. Sweet. So, Lunar 2 Eternal Blue complete. That's actually the name of the game. Complete. There's a disc. Not complete, no manual, but the case looks in decent condition. Now, I'm sure this is one of those games that had lots of extra stuff that came with it. That's disc 2, disc 3, disc 1, and what is this? The making of. Okay, so it has all the disc. Sweet. Let's see. I'll try disc one. Disc one's usually always in the worst shape of games like this. Oh man. I don't even think that's been resurfaced. That's sweet. That's sweet right there. I thought I ordered three things. I wonder if they're coming in two separate packages. Let's see. I'm pretty sure 28. Because they ran my debit card twice, which means to me two separate shipments. Better not be two separate shipping charges. So, all right, Lunar 2 and Panzer Dragoon Orta in good condition. I don't have to fucking return them. How's the disc on this one? May have been resurfaced in the past. All right. So sweet. We have those. And here in a few nights, I'll be opening all those. Hopefully my other GameStop shipment isn't in there. I'll double check that. And if it is, I'll turn on the camera again. I'll see you in a couple nights for the Nintendo Switch presentation and some unboxing. What up, everyone? We're back. It is now a few nights later. It is Thursday night. I just got home from work. I'm still in the shirt and tie. It is 5:42, which means we are T-minus 2 hours and 18 minutes until the Nintendo Switch presentation goes live here on Mountain Time. And as you can see, I'm hype. I'm hype! I can't wait. Something tells me this is going to be big. This is going to be huge. Unlike this hat, which is this is the fit on it. Wait. Oh, that's a little bit better. Not much. But my see on the head. Sweet. So we're going to do Nintendo Switch these pickups. Let me tell you what's going to go on. I'm going to do the rest of my pickups I got for this video, and then we're going to do another one, another little swipe, and I may go live a couple times, live during the Switch presentation to give some reaction to what's happening, what's being announced, price, release date, games, and then I'll come back with a little break it down what I thought of the presentation. But something tells me Nintendo is the ball's on the tee, baby. They can knock it out the park, or they can swing and miss. Either way, it's going to be a long night, because it started at 9 o'clock for me, and I'm going to be way too hyped to, like, go to bed. I'm going to have to, you know, I'm going to do the video, then I'm going to go online for reactions on places like NeoGAF or Reddit. I'm not going to do that during. That kind of spoils it for me when I'm trying to follow NeoGAF threads while watching a presentation during E3 or something, because there's always downers like, this fucking sucks, this game's going to suck, fuck this console. I want to fucking live it. And that's whether it's Nintendo or Sony or Microsoft or whatever, I want to be able to have what I feel about it. Like, hey, this looks nice, or, yeah, I'm not sure about this one. So, I may be up all night, and then Nintendo's doing their treehouse tomorrow morning, 7:30 my time. Needless to say, I may need something to get me through the next 12 to 15 hour period. So, let's get the glass. Let's get the Costco brand Kirkland vodka. Pour some in. That's good. And let's get some wings. I've been sitting on this can. A sugar-free Red Bull, by the way. Sugar-free. Because, you know, I'm trying to watch it here. For months. I think I've had it since October. Just like, I'm going to have a vodka Red Bull some night. And then the nights never come. Until now. Cheers, everyone. Oh, I forgot how much I hate Red Bull. Mmm. Tasty. Let's get to these pickups. Because something tells me, if I had to wait till tomorrow or 2 days from now and be like, oh, here's this game, fuck it. Here's this, fuck it. When's the Nintendo Switch going to be out? Well, fuck this game. Anyway. So we have our next package here from GameStop. They separated my order into two packages. As you saw earlier in the video, there's Panzer Dragoon Orta and Lunar 2 Eternal Blue Complete. This one, it's feeling a bit light. So I'm hoping for a 3-for-3 GameStop order in getting the cases with the games that I ordered. But it looks like I may be 2-for-3. And this one, just from the weight of it, may be going back to GameStop. Because, yeah, it was a good deal, but I want cases. You had cases in the picture of the product, so give me my damn case. Alright? Sorry. That's how I feel. Let's go on the other end. They have that one taped up too well. Jesus. There we go. Please be a case, please be a case, please be a case, please be a case. Please. No. Yeah, it's going to be a return. That's a shame. Damn. It's a Lunar Silver Star story. But, no case, no buy. That'll be going back to GameStop. Let's see, I got it last night. I got 7 days. Sometime this weekend, I gotta make a run to GameStop. Get rid of that. 2-for-3 from GameStop. Oh well, I guess that's how it goes sometimes. Alright, let's do this big one, because I know what it is. I got this bad boy from Steam. Steam! What'd you get from Steam? I've been sitting on a Steam gift card here in my stack of gift cards I've had for over a year. I was waiting for the winter sale. And I went through, like, I think it was about 12 to 15 hours ago in the winter sale, about a week or so ago, or I guess about 2 weeks ago. And there was just nothing that I said, God, I gotta spend money on this game. Just, And I searched everything. I went to shooters, because I'm kind of into shooters right now, you know. I did buy Raiden 4, because I don't have it. I have Raiden 5 on the Xbox One. So I got that. But I'm like, what am I going to do with this $50 gift card? I've got a huge Steam library, but 40% of Steam's library was released last year. Did you know that? 40%. And it's really full of bullshit. Full of early access or shovelware or just crap games that nobody should be spending a dime on. And I was really, really just kind of down on the service. What can I do with this $50 gift card other than let it sit here or sell it at a loss? And then I saw this was on sale. I got the Steam Link. Steam Link with the Steam controller. This is really awesome. My PC is not the most powerful thing in the world, but I do have a pretty big library of Steam games. And I've tried to mostly use it or only buy games that I can run. Not buy games that, well, I hope someday, maybe in a year or two, I'll have a rig that can run it. No, I buy games that I can run for super cheap, which means I have a huge, like, 300 game plus library of Steam games. Well, with this, I'll be able to connect the PC to my TV and play the games on my TV, which is where an old console gamer like me likes to play. I'm not sitting here in front of my PC, but sitting in front of the TV over there on the big screen, on the comfy couch. This will make it possible. Also, this can do things. It basically will mirror my PC over Ethernet or wireless. If there's anything that I want to do on my PC that I can't do, like through my Roku or through one of the consoles, like if I download a movie or something legally, then Steam Link will help me kind of interconnect and make it so I can watch it on the big screen. So Steam Link, Steam Controller, I believe together they were like $40-something dollars. And then I bought Raiden. I think I paid out of pocket $5 for the game and this with the gift card that I've had for over a year. So that's a nice little piece of hardware. Unfortunately, it uses an HDMI slot. And especially when the Switch releases in 2 months, those are in short supply. In fact, they're gone. I may need to get one of those splitters. All right, let's see. Let's do these. Let's do all the ones from Amazon. This one's from Best... No. Yeah, this one is from Best Buy. I know what it is, too, because I spent $10. This was an impulse purchase for sure. Don't even know if I'm going to like this game, but just for the price and what it is, you know, I picked it up. Ah, get out of there. Goodness gracious. Double mailer's kicking my ass. It's Homefront Revolution Steelbook. So, pretty cool. I did not pay $39.99 for it. It was $10. It was $9.99. So I think the Steelbook was exclusive to Best Buy. So that's pretty neat. I have seen some game footage. I know at least the PC version was or is broken. I know either Total Biscuit or Jim Sterling was kind of making fun of it on their YouTube channel. But hey, $10. These three right here I know are all from Amazon. I got so much stuff coming from Amazon. I know I got one more pre-order coming next week. And oh, yeah! This was a pre-order. I believe this was released on December 27th. So I'm just now getting around to opening up Shantae Half Genie Hero. Awesome. It's the Risky Beats edition, baby. Risky Beats includes a CD with 30 music tracks from the game. Awesome. And of course, this goes really well with the two Shantae games I picked up from Limited Run Games a couple months ago. I am just Shantae-ing it up. And in fact, right now, the Humble Indie Bundle on PC, speaking of Steam games, is doing a Humble Bundle, and in their dollar tier, their lowest price tier, is a Shantae game that you should definitely pick up. Just go donate a dollar, put it all towards charity, download that Shantae game and give it a whirl, because these are some really awesome games. And now I've got this. I know it's on PS4 as well, maybe on Xbox One. But of course, I had to get that Wii U version. Save Sequin Land again. That should be the Mario tagline for the Mario Switch game. Save Peach again. All right, moving on. Ooh, there's two things in here. All right, this is a game I've had my eye on for quite some time, Republic. I believe it dropped to 10 or 12 bucks, and it's been around 9 or 10 before. Then it raised up to close to 20. Then it dropped real quick, so I went and jumped in before, you know, it starts becoming out of print and not carried, and maybe jumps to around the 20s or even 30s for a price. Let's go ahead and jump in. It was originally made as an iOS game ported to Android. I think I have episode 1 on my Android. But then they made it and for PS4. It's a stealth game. You kind of control, as far as I know, you control like the cameras. And you can set off things to alert guards elsewhere and help your main character or the main character navigate through the levels by kind of manipulating them, telling her where the guards are with use of the cameras and setting off alarms and setting off things for distractions. I believe that's how it happens. So yeah, hacking gameplay, you hack stuff. All right, the other one, speaking of impulse purchase, I had no intention of getting this probably till this Black Friday, like 2017 Black Friday at the earliest. But Deus Ex Mankind Divided has dropped like a fucking rock into the damn ocean. This just came out like a couple months ago. $60 full price game. Went down to about $35, $35 on Black Friday. And then December was down to $25, and you kept going. I got this for $15. And if you were a Best Buy GCU member and went into and bought it on Best Buy, it was $15 with your discount. You could have got this, I believe, for $11.99. $11.99, brand new game. And according to reviews of people who played it, it's not dog shit. It's a really good game. It just got lost in the ton of games that have come out over the past couple months for PS4 and a little bit Xbox One. Just kind of got lost in the shuffle. $15 for this. And it's not broken. It's a good series. It's a good game. It was definitely worth pulling the trigger on Amazon and picking that up. Okay, they put two games in an envelope, Amazon did. I can tell that this is one game in a box. I just don't understand. You're wasting a whole box for this. I wanted to pick this up. I wanted to pick this up because I have the sequel pre-ordered, and it's probably going to be, I think it releases next week. It's either next week or the week after. I'll be getting it in the mail from Amazon. It'll be on the next pickup video, I'm sure. This is Gravity Rush Remastered. I watched gameplay. I didn't really know about this. It was made for the Vita. Then I saw all the hype Gravity Rush 2 was getting, and I saw there was a remastered version, and I checked out some gameplay, and it just looked absolutely beautiful. And nothing but good things said about it from everybody who's played it. It's a Japanese-type game. If you're into that, you know, it's got that kind of art style, that kind of sensibility. I want to play it. I may have to start with Gravity Rush 2 when that gets here, because I'm kind of really psyched to get that. But this main character I know is called Cat. She has a cat. And yeah, I really can't wait to give this a whirl. The art director, or one of the art people for Gravity Rush 2, I don't know if you can really see in the artwork there, but I guess a complaint, I guess, about the game was, you know, this girl's outfit is really impractical. Like, I mean, come on, dude, really? So this dude, and the thread's up on NeoGAF, it's kind of hilarious, he went and he drew like 8 or 10 drawings showing how she gets into this outfit. is actually kind of adorable. Like, you know, how she wraps the white stuff around her leg, and she does, like, really? You think, like, this takes her, like, at least 45 minutes to an hour just to get this outfit on, way before she does hair or makeup. All right. Speaking of limited run games from earlier, here's a package from Limited Run Games, and I know what it is because I know what I ordered from them. I actually have this downloaded on PS4, but I was really kind of psyched when they offered it as the limited run physical release. It's a great game, I think. Really cool narrative. And anyway, there's the standard postcard. Maybe you can tell what the game is from the welcome from or greetings from Wyoming. There's the limited run sticker that comes with everything. Here's me drinking some more vodka Red Bull. And the game. Great game. I suggest to you, I mean, I'm sure this is going to be really hard to find physically, or really expensive to find at the very least, now that the limited run game thing is over. Although they did set aside a certain amount of copies for the developer to sell on their website at a later date. I don't know when that's happening, so maybe be on the lookout. Firewatch. Firewatch. Really awesome game. Peace, solitude, the great outdoors. Really cool narrative, really cool story. I suggest to download it if you see it on sale on the PlayStation Network. Definitely jump in and buy it. It's really awesome. Two more. Should we do the big one first or the small one? Because these are from people, not Amazon, not let's do this one because I've already opened it. Because I was like, I looked at this package, I'm like, this is really small. What the hell did I order that can fit in this envelope? So I kind of opened it real quick and saw that it was a PS4 game, and I've left it in there, so I really don't know what it is. But yes. I was really hyped when I saw that this was now a physical release. And Wild Guns Reloaded, a remake of the old Super Nintendo game, which if you want to buy and play the Super Nintendo version, if you want to buy it, it's not cheap. It's not cheap. I believe this one is $30. And it's got some new characters, some new art, some new bosses, but really awesome. I wanted to buy it directly from Natsumi because they were giving away a limited edition keychain, I believe, with the game, but they were sold out of them both on their website and through Amazon. The third party seller, Natsumi, was selling it for $29.99 with free ship. The third party seller, I think, was selling the game for $31 with $3 ship. So I paid a little more. But I don't think it's coming back in stock. I think it's a limited run. It's pressed a few physical copies because they're expecting most people to download it, which you can. So I don't think this is going to be seeing a big print run or even a second print run. I could be wrong. I would like to be wrong. You know, I don't want it to maintain value. I want people to be able to play it. So really cool that they did that, and I cannot wait to dive into that. I never played the Super Nintendo version. 6 o'clock, we are 6:01, less than 2 hours from the Nintendo Switch. Wait, I can't do math. 3 hours. It starts at 9 o'clock my time. This whole time, I've been saying 2 hours. 3 hours. I knew that didn't sound right. Okay, I don't know what I ordered here. What the fuck? Okay, if I die of poisoning. This guy, like, put an envelope inside an envelope inside an envelope. One. Two. And then there's the third. Two. One, two, three. It's fucking packed well. Goodness gracious me. Like doing surgery. I gotta get the envelope out. Thanks for that. I really appreciate the help with that pull tab on that this bubble mailer. How in the... Why? Why? I'm assuming this is an eBay purchase. Okay. I need to check that envelope the Wild Guns came in, just in case. Maybe the keychain's in there and I just missed it. I have no idea what this is. So, I should dig my knife in there. There's another envelope inside this! Thank you, whoever this person is, for your awesome envelope inside an envelope inside an envelope inside envelope inception packaging. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. This was another one where I come home one night and Amazon's doing it, or not Amazon, eBay. God, I'm just can't. I'm talking great tonight. eBay's got another one of those 15 off 75. And I'm thinking like, you know, I got the money right now. Just hit it. Go big. Take $15 off something you've always wanted. Something you've held that issue of Die Hard Game Fan and dreamt about lying in your bed at night, reading your new magazine, going, oh, I hope I can get that game. And here I am, 25 whatever years later, holding in my hand Elemental Gearbolt from Working Designs. It is, if I'm correct, an RPG slash shooter? A shooter with RPG elements? An RPG with shooter elements? I think they say here on the back. Hold on. This gripping hybrid shooting RPG unfolds by means of heart-stopping full 3D action levels interspersed with gorgeous hand-drawn animation scenes. Fully supporting the GunCon. Oh, holy shit. I didn't know. I gotta get a GunCon. This fucking thing supports the GunCon? Standard light gun analog and standard pads. The ultimate shooting game has arrived. This is the game for which Visa was invented. This is the game for which Visa was invented. Pull out your plastic, kids. Well, let's open it up and check the condition. Oh, hello. It's got the manual. Obviously was a rental from Town Video in Upper Montclair, New Jersey. Thank you, Upper Montclair, New Jersey, for not tossing your manuals, Town Video. It's not the best shaped manual. There's a few dings and nicks on especially the corners, like right there. But, I mean, who's bitching? Check out that artwork. Pretty neat. Let's get to that disc, baby. Oh, fuck! Disc was rattling around. It does not make a happy me. There's a couple light scratches. Nothing too bad. No Blockbuster or rental sticker around the circle here. That's awesome. Elemental Gearbolt. Let's put it back. Make sure it stays in there. Wow. Nice to end this segment on a couple cool retro game and remake of a retro game. And now, here's what my plan is. I mean, this is 25 minutes long. The other one, this means we're already at 30 minutes. If you're sitting here this long, have a drink on me. I'm going to sit here for the next 3 hours. Well, for about an hour, hour and a half, I'm going to sit here and just get hype. I think I'm going to go get some B-dubs, as long as I don't drink too many more of these. Some Buffalo Wild Wings, for those of you who don't know, because it's Thursday night. It's Boneless Thursday. I got a gift card, and I ain't got nothing else to do but eat wings and watch Nintendo Switch presentation. Nothing else to do. What a life. So I'll be back with some like reaction and tell you what my thoughts. I'll try to keep it short because the video is already going to run long. So swipe, or I think YouTube has one of those little scene edits called Switch. If it does, switch! A countdown from 60 seconds. That's the most hype countdown ever. Oh, what's gonna happen? My battery's actually low, so I'm not gonna be doing any reactions during this. I'll be back afterwards. But 3, 2, 1, baby, let's go. What up, everyone? It is the morning after the Nintendo Switch presentation. I did film some thoughts last night after the presentation. However, like I said, my battery was low and my battery went out and my phone died right like mid-sentence. So I charged the phone and here I am the next morning. I've got my coffee right here. I'm sitting here. I've got on the big screen the Treehouse Live streaming, showing off games, and they showed a little bit of hardware too, but mostly showing off the games. Before I get into my thoughts, last night I was, you know, walking around the apartment and I looked down at into a chair and I saw I had more pickups. And it's technically a pickup video. I forgot that I got these. They're sitting in a bag. This is the Williams Collection Pinball Hall of Fame. It's a great game, and I know this because I have it. I don't know why I bought it again. I don't have that. I have that other one. And then I brought it home, and I looked on my Wii shelf, and right there on my Wii shelf, sitting on top of a stack, was this. So, second copy of that. And I got Rockstar Table Tennis, a game I did not have, for 99 cents. Nice little find there. Complete. So is the other one. But adding that to the collection, the pinball collection, I have no idea what I'm going to do with that. Also got some hardware accessories. I actually went out and found these. I was out game hunting for the $5 game box. And I don't collect hardware or cables or controllers for the game box. So I bought these. This is the components for the Xbox 360. So, got those. Is it for the 360? Might be for the original Xbox too. No, it's for the 360. Alright. And I got another set of these. These Nintendo composites. I've got two extras now. And I found both extras at that thrift store for $2.50 each. It put $5, was a half price day. So that's really cool. I'm sitting on some extras for when I find Super Nintendo's or N64's where they lost the hookups. Here they are. Cool little find here. This is the DualShock 1 for the PlayStation 1. Ice blue, baby. It's kind of see-through there on the back. Really cool. And once again, they had $5 on it. Right there. $2.50, half price. And finally, really cool find on that day. This PlayStation 1 fishing controller for Bass Landing. Bass Landing fishing controller. Right there. $5 once again, but $2.50, half price. They say it works. Cable's in good condition. Everything seems to be nice. Buttons are... Analog stick is good. Really awesome. Check out that fishing controller. Alright, so that does complete the pickups for this episode. Now, Nintendo Switch thoughts. First of all, I am so happy. So happy that I decide when I'm watching these things, whether it's the Nintendo Switch presentation, whether it's E3, Microsoft, Sony, I sit there and I watch it and I formulate my own opinions. Because if I was sitting there following NeoGAF threads or cheap ass gamer threads and seeing all the fucking negativity, oh, this fucking sucks. How dare they fucking charge $2.99? Like, so I form my own opinions on the stuff and then go see what everybody's reaction. And of course, in typical internet fashion, people are overreacting. First of all, the price, $299. I know the rumors were $250, and people seem to be fine with the $249.99. But then, when they announced $299.99, people were like, oh, fool, what the fuck is Nintendo thinking? Like, listen. If $249 had you with your credit card out ready to pre-order, and $299 is making you go, oh, fuck, I'll never own a Switch. I'll wait for a fucking price drop. If $50 is making or breaking you, get out of this hobby. If $50 is preventing you from putting food on the table or keeping the lights on in your place, you're in the wrong hobby, all right? The wrong hobby. $250, $300, wait a month. Wait till April. Okay, if you had $249 ready in March, but you don't have $299, work for a month and try to save $50. Drink coffee at home and stop going to Starbucks for a month. Boom, save $50. That's my opinion on that. $300, yes, I know you can get an Xbox One now for like less than $250. You can probably get a PS4 for less than $300. At least during holidays, you can. It is what it is. Alright? I also see some people, and I know this is without a game. So, you want to get Zelda, you're in for $360 on launch day. Just to get Zelda. Yeah. But I see some people on, like, it's like gaff posts, like, man, if I want to play Zelda properly, I've got to be in for $440 on launch. Because they say, well, I gotta get a pro controller because I'm a hardcore gamer, man. And I like proper controls for my video games, man. Like, you haven't even held the Joy-Con yet. You haven't held it either in your hands out here or in its little grip or with the tablet. You have no idea what it feels like to instantly think you need to buy a $70 pro controller on day one just so you can properly play Zelda. Get the fuck out of here with that shit. You want to play Legend of Zelda, it's $360 on launch day. System with the game. That's what it is. Are there other things on the Switch you want to play? Buy the damn Switch. If there's not so far, don't fucking pre-order it. Wait till the holiday. I'm kind of maybe thinking waiting till the holiday, because the one thing that really blew my mind on the Nintendo Switch presentation was Super Mario Odyssey. I thought it looked awesome. And when they were running that trailer, I was sitting here with the biggest fucking smile on my face going, I can't wait to play this game. That was one thing. It's like, this is why I want a Switch. This is why I want this console, is Super Mario Odyssey. So maybe I'm waiting till holiday for Super Mario Odyssey, and then I'll go back and get Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. I'll go back and get Splatoon 2. I'll go back and get Mario Kart 8 Deluxe and anything else in between. Alright, launch day is March 3rd. That's right around the corner. Right around the corner. That is less than 2 months away. That's amazing. I really think Nintendo is dropping the ball promotion and marketing wise, not holding it back a week and releasing it on March the 10th, because March the 10th is Mario Day. M-A-R-1-0, Mar-E-O. Yeah, it's kind of corny, but it's kind of cool. And it's a Friday, March 10th, Mario Day. Then again, they don't have anything Mario prepared for launch day, as far as I can tell. Maybe they could have done something, some sort of a port or enhanced version of Super Mario Run for day one as like a downloadable title or loaded onto the system for Mario Day. But that's just kind of, you know, that'd be a little extra. March 3rd is great. Let's get it out. Give me. March 3rd, $299. I paid $400 for my PS4. The Xbox, my Xbox One was a gift but I think I know what she paid. I think she paid about $300 for the Xbox One. I mean, people are comparing a launch of a console to these consoles that have now been out 3 years. Well, you gotta compete in the current market. PS4 is already $300. They can't do that. Like, well, fuck me. Nintendo's on their own time, I guess. If like $300 is too much, don't fucking buy it. Wait for a price drop. Wait for a holiday bundle. It's all good. Just do it. Ain't nobody forcing to be there on March 3rd or April 3rd or this summer. Jump in whenever the hell you want. If you're fine, there's plenty of great stuff coming out, especially for PS4 this year. Wait, it's all good. Things I didn't like. The first game they showed at the presentation was 1-2 Switch, and they can fuck off with that. That should have been a pack-in. That should have been a throw-in, like a Nintendo Land, like, here's some shit, to try out, the concept of, you can bring it to a party, you can hook it up and hand a controller to your friend, and let's play together. I'm definitely not paying $60 or $50 for that game. It may be like Nintendo Land that I wait a year or so until that thing becomes $10 or $5, and then I'll just buy it at $5 because what the hell? I don't envision really ever playing it because I've said this before, my apartment is small. I don't entertain very often in here. So, plus there's not a lot of room to begin with. If I had two or three friends over, hey, let's play 1-2 Switch, and we have to stand this far apart and look at each other and go bang, like we would probably hit each other in the face when we draw, like, ow, damn, dude. And then, a trip to the emergency room ends all the fun. So no. Then they showed Arms. Arms looks pretty cool. So like it looked great. I hope the single player is up to snuff and fun as well, because local multiplayer will probably not be an option, at least in my place, unless I take it on the go, take it to somebody else's house. Online hopefully will be all right. Speaking of online, they announced that sometime this fall they're going to a paid online service, much like PSN, much like Xbox Live. Whatever. Once again, people are bitching online, and I kind of get it because Nintendo is third of the three as far as online capabilities and their networking and what they offer. We'll see if they make it worth the money. Right now, I mean, they said one free game download a month and one free NES Super Nintendo game per month as well, on top of that, with the price, plus discounts on games, sales, and what. When they have sales, you get extra sales, just like you do now for PlayStation and Xbox. But people just automatically shitting on it. Fucking LOL if they think I'm going to pay for a third download. Well, then don't. But you can't be like, well, Microsoft can do it because Microsoft is, and Sony can do it, but fuck Nintendo for trying to make money on their online, bleh. You can't say, well, Nintendo should just only offer free online for me. I'll gladly pay $90 a year for Xbox Live, but never, ever, 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 ever will I ever, ever pay for Nintendo, bleh. Then don't. I pay for PS Plus. I pay for Xbox Live. Will I pay for Nintendo? I don't know. I usually find deals on this stuff. $60 a year subscription for one of these, but I find a subscription card or something for 40 or 35. Xbox Live, I pay for Bing re with Bing Rewards points. So we will see on that. I'm neither here nor there about it. We'll see what they offer. If the service is, and I don't play online a whole lot anyway. I'm a single player gamer mostly. So we'll see. I don't have a problem paying for it if it's something worthwhile. And Xbox Live with the games they give you and the deals with Gold and PlayStation Plus with the free games and the extra deals you get on their sales have been proven worthy to me. All right, so there. Let's see what else. I'm glad I held off on buying any DLC for Mario Kart 8 on the Wii U, because it looks like Mario Kart 8 Deluxe is basically a Game of the Year edition with extra content on top of that. Now it makes me wonder, because I really haven't bought any DLC yet for Smash Bros. On Wii U. So I'm kind of thinking, should I hold off on getting things like Ryu or Bayonetta on Smash Bros. On Wii U and see where they're at with that, if we're getting kind of an enhanced port, or if it's going to make the whole game entirely. Remake it, make a whole new Smash. Let's see. What else? Skyrim, whatever. It's cool. Splatoon 2 looked awesome. I see people bitching about that. This just looks like a content update. Why are they doing this? This looks like more like a Madden 2007 to Madden 2008 type of sequel instead of a true game sequel. I'm like, all new single player, all new maps, all new this, all new... It's a fucking new game. What more do you want? What more do you want? We should have been a pack-in. It should have been free. God, I hope these people are being sarcastic. It's kind of hard to read sarcasm in forum comments, so I really hope they're being sarcastic. Yeah. But see. The launch lineup isn't looking too hot. Alright, Legend of Zelda is pretty much the rock. And then everything else looks... there's going to be a Bomberman title that looks okay, but I don't know how much I'm going to pay for it. Apparently there's a racing game I haven't seen much of that's going to launch. Again, a couple other games I've heard of, and then, like, you know, Just Dance. Whatever. But Zelda's going to have to hold the fort, apparently, until... Why isn't ARMS ready? ARMS looks about as ready. Why are they holding that off? Why are they holding off Splatoon until summer? Like, some vague summer. That could be August. That could be June. They need to kind of make sure that releases are ready. But I really think they should have had something else with Zelda. I think they're putting too much eggs in the 1-2 Switch basket. Because that's going to be ready launch. I don't think... That's going to go over. That'll be like a fart in church. Anyway, I have not pre-ordered one yet. I saw they're up on Best Buy. I don't want to pre-order from Best Buy because I don't have a Best Buy here, so I can't go pick it up. I don't get any discounts at Best Buy. Target has it up, but I've got this TV on my Target card. I don't want to add another $360 for switching a game to my Target card. Amazon, I don't know if the consoles have gone up yet. Apparently, the Master Edition of Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, which has all the collectible stuff and a Master Sword statue, apparently that went up in the middle of the fucking night, like really, really early this morning, and it is gone on Amazon. So thanks for that, guys. I really appreciate you releasing that when the scalpers can pick it up and the people who actually want it, who have normal jobs, are in bed asleep. So thanks for that. So it's really looking, here we are, just less than a day, less than a full 24 hours since the damn thing's been announced, this, you know, super special edition for Legend of Zelda. And apparently it's already not really available. It's already gone. So whatevs, we'll see about that. I want to pre-order from Amazon. I think GameStop.com has them up, but only in bundles, and that fucking sucks. You get the Switch and like five games for $530. It's like, get out of here with this shit. Get out. You make me pre-order the Switch and Zelda and four games I have no interest in buying at launch. Fuck you guys. Maybe I'll go into store today and see what's up when I have to return that Lunar game that they didn't send me a case and see if I can get it there. But I really want to do it through Amazon, so we will see about that. So yeah, that's my Switch thoughts. Unless you absolutely positively must play Zelda day one on the Switch, you can probably wait at least till fall. Maybe this summer when there's some more games out, when they get Splatoon and Mario Kart out, and then you can get Zelda. And that might be worth it then. But then again, $300 is not a deal breaker to me. It doesn't, you know, break my back. So if I can get a pre-order on Amazon or maybe GameStop, I might get it day one, get Zelda, and see where I'm at with that. What do you guys think? Did you watch it? What do you think of the Switch? I know this is mostly kind of a retro channel, sort of. That's what I mostly go after when I'm game hunting, is retro games. But as you've seen the past few months, I love my PS4, and I love the Wii U, and I'm really looking forward to the Switch. This is going to be a long video. This is 20 minutes of me jabbering after 27 minutes of me jabbering. Thanks for watching me jabber. Like and subscribe if you wish. Comment below. Tell me about what you think about the pickups or about the Nintendo Switch. And I'll see you next time. I got a $5 game box episode coming as soon as I get it uploaded and edited. And that should be coming pretty soon. Take care. I will see you next time.